Hi. There we go. Hey, Beatrice. Hi. Right, let's just jump into it. We are supposed to do the second bad end for Haruka tonight, and this starts from the last choice that we made. Over here, I believe this is the one. We saw the bad ending that came from, heard it from Futaki-san, and then let's choose the other one, which is saw it in the class register, which for some reason is supposed to be a better choice. Which I'm not entirely clarified at this moment in time why this is a better choice to lie to her. But sure. It was on the class register. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't mean to pry. Then why is this such a tragedy if, when you hear it from Futaki-san? I don't know. Okay, maybe that will be clarified. Haruka-san murmured something under her breath. What was that? So anyway, I just wanted to tell you that. I mean, I said it before too. So wait, what did we say to her? I'm so. It was something about your classroom is all the way at the back of the school, right? I bet you get a nice sun in there. Okay. Okay, I guess that's what it was about. So, I thought I'd like to come visit you in your class for a change sometimes. Wow, I blurted out something strange without meaning to. Haruka-san was pop-eyed. Yeah, that's right. I was feeling incredibly embarrassed. Hey, irascible kitty, how's it going? You're welcome. Haruka-san looked back over her shoulder as she turned to leave. Yeah. Okay, I got it.
Bye-bye, Riki-kun.
Right. Bye-bye, Haruka-san. I watched as Haruka-san walked away. After school. I was taking out the garbage bags when I spotted a familiar face. Good, what's up? Oh no, what's happening? Kud dropped the black plastic bag she'd been carrying onto the concrete. It made an unpleasant sound like that of ceramics and metal rubbing together. Well, no, but what's wrong? Your face is pale. Kud started to say something, but then shook her head. Kud left, swaying a little on her feet. I wonder what was up with Kud. Aren't you a lovely presence? Sorry, huh? It was Futaki-san, a grey cardboard box in her arms. Do you want some help with that? Futaki-san rejected my offer without a second thought, and then proceeded to set down the box in the garbage area. As she straightened her back, she began to mutter to herself under her breath. There was a pile of books in her hands. I glanced at their spines. The titles all had to do with aerospace engineering, propulsion, and things like that. She sure reads some tough books. Nothing. I stood up and stepped out of the garbage area. After I had gone a few steps, I halted and looked back. Futaki-san was still in the same spot, flipping through the books. What was she doing? Tilting my head in puzzlement, I walked back toward the classroom. That evening in the hallway. Okay, this seems familiar. Another day draws to an end. Through the windows, I could hear the various clubs having their activities. Is this the same conversation? I guess so.
Riki-kun!
As I walked along gloomily, a voice called out and made me stop. It belonged to Haruka-san. Is it really that scary?
してる! Marty
Haruka-san pulled on her own cheeks and made a face. She said this while frivolously laughing at the nonsense. Haruka-san? I started to talk, then let out a sigh. Really, I wondered if she already knew about the whole affair. What kind of face would she make if I told her someone had instructed me not to get near her? Well, most of the time she was just stringing me along anyway. It's nothing. My answer was rather blunt. Why was I worrying so much about this? It was somewhat upsetting. Why? When Futaki-san said those words, I had certainly felt my heart rebel strongly against them. What was wrong with me? Haruka-san looked surprised for a moment. What,
Haruka-san?
If I said I didn't? I said the words without thinking. I felt a numbing tingle somewhere in my heart as I said it. Her words surprised me. Without even a displeased look on her face after my unkind words, she just tilted her head with her hands joined behind her. Haruka-san asked me with a serious face. Oh, we get to make another choice. I mean, yes, of course. We have time for you. Yeah. Haruka-san guided me to a classroom and I stepped in. Interior-wise, it should have been the same as my own classroom. Yet, it was different. The bulletin board in the back, the arrangement and number of desks. There were just minute differences, but they added up to create a strange feeling as though I had entered a different realm altogether. I have this feeling, probably a very, very similar feeling, when I entered different Lidls. The supermarket, I mean. Because they all kind of have the same layout. And I'm used to the one next to me, but when I'm, I don't know, in another town, in my hometown, for example, and I enter one and it's the same layout, I kind of like feel transported across space and time somewhat. It's a very weird feeling. It just has enough differences to obviously point out it's not the exact same, but so many similarities that it creates a weird of a sensation just being in there.
Hey,
Takasaki, how's it going? Haruka-san murmured quietly. Without realizing it, Haruka-san had basically voiced my thoughts. It's surprising there's no one here. Usually a student or two should still remain in the class at this hour. I wondered which class this room belonged to. Needless to say, the time schedule written on the blackboard was different from the one I usually saw. Haruka-san took me to the back of the classroom where there was an open space. The evening sun was shining through the window. Aw, this is so cute. Haruka-san plopped herself down on the floor.
Hi, Riki-kun, sit.
Haruka-san patted the floor next to her. Haruka-san, won't you get your skirt dirty? Sitting around on the floor without a care in the world, she really was like a child. Smiling wryly, I sat down next to her. From the floor, I looked up at the window. Orange-colored light streamed in to fill the room. From my lowered perspective, I discovered that the classroom really did feel larger. Wait. What's this? Well, I have, but why an earphone? Haruka-san brought out her cell phone. Okay. She slid a part of the cell phone up, revealing the keypad with a small sliding noise followed by a click. Oh, music time. That's why Beatrice was doing the music notes. Okay, I see. I opened my mouth, feeling a little bewildered. Isn't that sort of a non-sequitur? Haruka-san shushed me while placing one finger against my lips. Again? Haruka-san withdrew her finger and murmured. Haruka-san plugged in the pair of earphones and handed me the one with the longer cord. There was an L marked on the earphone. Finally, I understood what Haruka-san wanted me to do. Okay. I clumsily scooted closer to Haruka-san. For an instant, I caught a pleasant, citrusy scent wafting from her hair. Soon we were shoulder to shoulder. Regardless of our uniforms being in the way, I felt awkward pressed against the warmth of her body. A slightly strange and asynchronous melody began to play through the earphones. Haruka-san, this song, it's kind of weird. Oh, you made it? You made it that long ago? Wow, that's no time ago at all. Haruka-san, are you telling me that you have some kind of teenage amnesia? Anyway, setting that aside, what's this song called? I silently swiped Haruka-san's cell phone and punched the next song button. I ignored Haruka-san's protests and continued to hit the next button. After a few presses, I found a girly pop song with a good tempo and finally returned to the cell phone. Only by name. I think I remember seeing it on a TV program for her new release. Oh, well, anyway, it's a good song. The song ended and the next one started. Why is the next song an enka? It was definitely not my taste. This song's about going up north to see the sea. So, no, not really. I'm pretty sure it said magnolias. Ugh, what is English? Next was let's take an DA train. It was the most random conversation. Wanna go to the wind instrument club and ask sometime? Hey, wait, don't. You better not do that. Why did you suggest it then, Riki? The number on the cell phone screen was going down. It was displaying the number of songs left on the playlist. Starting at 13, it went down one by one. There were a lot of rather short songs, but by number 10, she was listening intently. What kind of music player is that goes down? Interesting. There were clean, calm, female vocals. It was a Western song. Oh, you listen to jazz music too. Really? Maybe it was because it was a remix, but the fuzzy voice was hard to hear. It could be like she said, or not. I couldn't really tell. I glanced over at Haruka-san. Noticing my gaze, she dropped a serious expression and started smiling. I was just thinking it would be nice if you were always this laid back. Maybe. The song ended. Haruka-san hit the stop button.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, see ya. Haruka-san and I went our separate ways. Haruka-san? After school, when I saw Haruka-san, I called out to her.
Riki-kun!
When Haruka-san recognized my voice, she gave a small, startled jump. You're the one who always runs into me. She was talking nonsense straight out of the bat, just as always. Put it that way too, huh? I see. Were you headed somewhere? Haruka-san had a hammer and pliers poking out of one of the pockets of her school uniform. How do you fit a hammer in a pocket? Is it like a mini hammer? It's pliers, yeah, I can understand. Okay. The other pocket was bulging as well. Sure, I'm not busy. Do what? What are you saying there, Haruka? What are you gonna destroy or break or... Haruka-san let out a relaxed sigh with a dreamy look on her face. Haruka-san whispered the question, still dreamy-eyed. Sure. Well, I nodded. I felt my heart picking up tempo for some reason. What are you gonna do, Haruka? Hey, Haruka-san. So, where exactly is this sticky stuff happening? Okay, got it. I pressed on the seat of the wooden bench. Haruka-san hammered on it from above. The cautious wrapping of the hammer went. Right, right, got it. I bent some of the plywood back. Like this? Haruka-san pulled out a tube of glue. She then applied it on the joint of the bench. Haruka-san, why are you doing bench maintenance? Okay, so she's not destroying, she's preparing. Okay. Good to know. Well, I mean, I get that, but... Furniture time. I get ya. I had completely forgotten about the furniture thing from last week. I get it. Are you sure you should be napping instead of going to class? Haruka-san softly stroked the back of the bench. Bench scene. I don't know. Oh, so it's a bench with a sentimental meaning. Gotcha. Well, I'm the vice president of the maintenance committee, so if you ask me to help, of course I will. Aww, Riki. Haruka-san mumbled, smacking herself lightly on the forehead. That's harsh. You forgot? I made a dumbfounded face as I stared at her with my hands on my waist. Well, it was something meaningful to me, at least. Haruka-san slipped the hammer and screwdriver back into her pocket. It looked like the job was finished. Something wrong? No problem. It makes me happy fixing up stuff not just for myself, but for everyone. When I said that, Haruka-san gave me a rather bemused smile. Right when Haruka-san opened her mouth to continue.
その bench は廃棄予定だったのよ。なお、エリキ。
No! There was a cold voice. Haruka-san. I looked over my shoulder and there she was.
昼休みに使用禁止の札を貼っておいたんだけどね。剥がしたのは誰かしら。
Haruka-san was silent. What are you talking about?
新しいベンチが入る予定なのよ。順次古いベンチは撤去するの。ささくれだった木で怪我したら危ないものね。また来た。
Haruka-san muttered.
あなたにももう話したわよね。直せば大丈夫だよ。
Haruka-san mumbled sullenly to herself.
大丈夫じゃないから言ってるんじゃないの。 業者に修理させると高くつくしね。執行部も許可済みなのに、何勝手なことをしているの、あなたは。
このベンチの方がいいよ。何回も言ったけど。
Haruka-san started to formulate a weak comeback, but Futaki-san cut her off.
そんなわがままは聞く必要がないわ。だから、サイグサ・ハルカ。あなたがやっていることは無駄なの。あなたにはこの間も注意したのに。
ay ay ay. Under the fiery scolding, Haruka-san hung her head in dejection. I noticed that her clenched fists were beginning to tremble.
掲示板の木枠、勝手に補修したでしょう。ホワイトボード化するときすごく邪魔だったのよ。あと、あなたのこの活動については。
わかってるよ。わかってること何度も言わないで。
Haruka-san's head snapped up as she cut Futaki-san off.
活動は。
わかってるからそんなこと。
Haruka-san yelled to drown out Futaki-san's voice. In her rejection of those words of reprimand, she shouted at the top of her lungs.
やめればいいんでしょ。
Haruka-san made as if to kick the bench. Haruka-san? But she let her foot drop back to the ground. It looked like her self-control had got the upper hand before she could actually kick it. Yeah, that's me! Sorry. I really needed some tea. In her irritation, Haruka-san began stomping her foot on the ground. The screwdriver slipped out of her pocket. In her blind rage, Haruka-san jolted it away. Haruka-san, quit it! Stop it, Haruka-san! I caught Haruka-san's arm and held her back as she tried to grab for Futaki-san.
何?逆切れ?みっともないわね、サイグサ・ハルカ。悪いのはあなたなのよ。分かってるって自分で言ってるのに情けないわね。
I somehow managed to drag Haruka-san, who had been planting her feet firmly on the ground, away from the bench. Futaki-san, I addressed her while I tried to turn Haruka-san away.
何?
Is it really necessary to preach at Haruka-san like this for the things she does?
やっちゃいけない理由も言ったわよ。
But even so, you still don't have to talk to her this way.You go, Riki. Yes, please. Let's go. As I began to defend Haruka-san, an insinuating tone crept into Futaki-san's voice.
友達だっけ?に代弁させるのね、あなたは。自分がしてることを邪魔する人間が悪いと。自分は感情的に暴れて、他人に主張させるの。自分の口で言いなさい。そんなことも言えないのよね、あなた。あなたはいつでもそう。他人の迷惑なんてどうでもいいのよね。他人を厄介ごとに巻き込んで。どうしようっていうの。最低ね。最低。
Haruka-san was gnawing on her lip. Haruka-san.
うん、そうね。ベンチの前で止めたわ。
Futaki-san had pulled out her cell phone and was making a call to somewhere.
回収して。お願いね。
After a short while, a group of prefects showed up.
院長、見つけましたか?
ベンチはどうしますか?
壊して。
Futaki-san, that's...
やめてよ!
嫌よ。さっさと壊して。
After a flat refusal, Futaki-san issued her order to the prefects.
どうしていつも、そういうことするの?
Haruka-san reached out her hand, but the orders were executed efficiently.The prefects promptly began to trash the small wooden bench. What is the point of completely trashing it? At least repurpose it for something else. This is clearly done just to hurt Haruka. Come on. Haruka-san gasped. At last, Haruka-san averted her gaze from the scene. After a few moments, with a horrible noise,The bench was split in two. It all happened so quickly. In an instant, what had been a bench had been reduced to mere scrap.
焼却炉に持って行って。
With an affirmative, the prefects dumped what was left of the bench into a wheelbarrow. What have you... Yeah... Poor bench, son. How could you do this right in front of her? Haruka-san's shoulders were trembling.
今度は清潔で頑丈なベンチが置かれるのよ。いらないものをいつまでも置いておいてもしょうがないでしょ。
I have some very, very bad words at the tip of my tongue. I'm gonna sip some tea so that they don't spill out. Excuse me. At Futaki-san's words, I felt my rage rising. Yeah, I know, right? My hand coiling into a fist, I took... Oh, my coaster is stuck to the, to the back of my mug. I was like, where's my coaster? Okay. My hand coiling into a fist, I took a step toward her. A sudden pressure stopped me. Haruka-san? Haruka-san had both of her arms wrapped around me. But she didn't have to do this. Not like this, she didn't. I tried to tear away from Haruka-san. When I heard Haruka-san yelling, I pulled myself together. What was alright? I glared at Futaki-san. Futaki-san merely stood there, indifferently, observing us. That was how she saw it.
不良分子を一掃できるチャンスだったのに。ナオエリキ、そんな厄介者と一緒にいるのはやめなさい。本当よ。
With that dismissive line, she left Haruka-san and me to ourselves. Haruka-san? Haruka-san was still holding me. You can let go now. It's over. Clutching onto me, Haruka-san shook her head a little. No matter what I said, Haruka-san just kept repeating that. It's fine. Though, it certainly wasn't fine. Anger was still simmering inside of me. However, that wasn't the only reason I sounded so ill at ease. If Haruka-san hadn't stopped me, detention, suspension, those words came to mind uninvited. I was sure that Futaki-san was hoping that everyone who got close to Haruka-san would end up like that. Even though my opponent was a girl. If I really had hit her, I would have gotten much more than just self-loathing afterwards. Letting the blood rise to my head, what had I been thinking? Haruka-san gave me a dry smile. Haruka-san, why? Why do we have to obey her? Are we just supposed to ignore what she's said and done to you?
Your hey. Recognition honors me.
Squid, good morning. How's it going? Thank you so much for the 41 monthies. That's a lot of months! You're not in the wrong here. That... something like that... The sound of the hammers beating away at the bench came back to me. It had been a horrible sound. That and the wailing of the breaking wood. It had felt like, besides just the bench, something precious was being destroyed before my very eyes. Adulting paperwork to take care of home insurance and all that crap. Ooh, good luck to you. Go do the adulting, we believe in you. And yeah, we're always here. Both on stream time and Discord, whenever you wanna chill and hang out and just talk about stuff. So no worries, you take care of the stuff. You got this. And there you go. You have pet pets from Beatrice. Good luck, pet pets. Thank you so much, Queen. Haruka-san muttered.
Shittedano, irekaeru koto. でも、あのベンチは結構思い入れもあって。
Futaki-san clearly made a spectacle out of it just to spite Haruka. It was very clearly not just about replacing an old bench. You said that earlier too, right? That you have memories with it.
でも、ダメだな、私。あいつに冷たく言われると気持ちが屈服しちゃってどうでもよくなって墓
からなくなっちゃって何もできないんだ。いつも繰り返し、繰り返しは嫌いじゃないんだけど、これだけは慣れないよ。いや、リキ君、ごめんね。
Haruka sunk weakly, bowed her head down deeply. You don't have to apologize.
Yes.
Haruka-san raised her head, showing a forced smile.
Tension, 回復回復!
Even though she said that, I could tell she was bluffing. Because, Haruka-san, isn't your left hand trembling? Even though you're putting on such a brave face.
またね、リキ君! Bye bye!
Rushing out that closing line, Haruka-san left at a run. I couldn't say anything at all to her. You don't have to pretend. Should I have told her that? All I could think was that Haruka-san's thoughts and mine, on some fundamental level, were not meeting.
Oof, okay, that was quite a bit to take in. All right. I see that we have quite a bunch of choices ahead, but they kind of coincide with the actual good ending up until the last one, right? Yes, and so basically we're doing a bit of a double dip of doing these choices. We get both, basically. We get to the both points. Not sure how that can fit in the stream, if it can. I would prefer tonight to not extend it too much. Obviously, I will stream a bit later because I started late, but yeah. We'll see how it goes. The sound of the bench being destroyed kept resounding in my ears to the point I couldn't sleep last night. They didn't have to go that far. Yeah, no, they definitely did not. I wonder why the disciplinary committee member or Futeki-san is so harsh toward Haruka-san. The day started with that running thought, running through my mind. In the middle of switching classrooms, I remembered that I had left my textbook behind, so I went back to the previous room for it. It's not something I often do, leaving something behind in class, but it's an honest mistake that could happen to anyone. The back door of the classroom rattled as I opened it. Textbook, textbook. Huh? The classroom was empty. Well, at least it was supposed to be. Haruka-san was there looking at the blackboard. What's she doing? Was she planning to write Haruka was here with the chalk again? If so, I should stop her. Haruka-san... Just as I was calling out to her, Haruka-san turned her head and saw me. Her face was ghastly pale. Her lips moved. Can't be... Her lips endlessly seemed to form those words. All of a sudden, she began to furiously move the blackboard eraser in her left hand. Haruka-san, I approached the teacher's desk. I'm sorry, this line reminds me of the Koroks in Breath of the Wild. Yahaha, you found me! Yes. We found you, Haruka. So she had been planning to do some graffiti there after all. I smiled wryly. You can do that, Haruka-san. The prefects will be after you again. Haruka-san's left sleeve was pure white with chalk dust. She must have been drawing something quite sizable on the board. What was I supposed to do with her? You really don't learn, do you, Haruka-san? Even after Masato yelled at you like that before. Haruka-san made the show of holding her head. Suddenly, Haruka-san's body stiffened. Futeki-san? The door had been flung open. From the corridor, Futeki-san was staring at us with an unreadable expression. Doing? I'm just here to grab a textbook I forgot.
何してるの?
What the heck is the urgency and the the emergency here? I'm so confused. Futaki-san was suddenly yelling. Wait a sec, Futaki-san. Behind the front of aggressive questioning, somehow I caught just a hint of panic or confusion. Like I said, I forgot one of my books. As I answered, slightly bewildered by how Futaki-san was acting, I was interrupted by Haruka-san. Eh? Her flat voice startled me. Futaki-san was silent. Haruka-san was staring at Futaki-san, her eyes ablaze. They were almost glowing with... what? The closest I could come to describing it was a deep, dark, and raw emotion. It was hatred. The air between them crackled with tension. The first one to look away was Haruka-san. She jerked her gaze away abruptly and left the classroom without another word. After I'd watched Haruka-san go, Futaki-san called to me over her shoulder. What are you talking about? If it's about the graffiti, Haruka-san didn't do it. Would you stop blaming her for every small thing that happens? It's no wonder she's always angry at you when you have such a witch hunt going on for her. Futaki-san let out a small breath. Apparently having assured herself of something, Futaki-san issued me one of her standard warnings. When she put it that way, even I had to agree. That's why I told her to stop, so it wouldn't cause a scene. Last time, it was a pain erasing the graffiti. That again? Didn't I already tell you I have no intention of listening to you? After all this, what are you saying now? Don't get the wrong idea. Haruka-san is a joker and a troublemaker, but that's not all she ever is. I know that for a fact. Ah, now that you mention it. Futaki-san took off walking without another word. Futaki-san, this conversation isn't over. Futaki-san didn't even look over her shoulder as she said it, and then she was gone. Ay, lord. I plainly understood that as a prefect, Futaki-san considered Haruka-san her enemy. I guess that they didn't want her rebellious pranks to infect the surrounding students. So, it's not like I couldn't see her side of it. She had taken it upon herself to fill this role. And she must have known she would be discriminated, hated, and shunned by many for it. But still, something was strange about Haruka-san's circumstances as well. Haruka-san had to have a reason to hate Futaki-san that much. If I assumed that, there's got to be something going on with Futaki-san.
The universe shares its
bounty. Oh, hey! Thank you so much for the raid. How's it going? Hope you had a nice stream. Yay. Yeah, there's got to be something going on. I thought back. Recalling the dangerous atmosphere from mere moments earlier, I let out a sigh. Aww. Cute owl hearty. Yes, yes, yes. Very, very cute. I love that emote. There were students doing work in the dorm head's room again today. I had come to ask the head of the boys' dorm for some replacement furniture. Thanks for your help.
Mate, Naoe-kun.
The girls' dorm head, who was busy tidying up some documents on her desk, called to me as I started to leave. Yes, what is it? Oh no! It's alright, take it easy and rest up. We all have those kinds of days. Huh, but isn't the committee meeting room right around the corner? Toss it in. If I did it like that, wouldn't they get angry? I like her, she's cool. The dorm head stretched her arms. Ah, my shoulders hurt, she muttered, patting her shoulder. Almost like a granny. The head prefect is sorta... Well, with the whole business between her and Haruka-san, I just didn't have a very good impression of her.
Ah, Futaki-san.
I should have just told her to call me senpai, she sighed to herself.
Your recognition honors.
Oh, hey, thank you so much for the second monthy of Prime. Oh, that's so cute. That's so sweet of you. Cat ears rule the world. Yeah, no cat ears tonight. Tonight is Little Buster's night, but there will be more cat ears on Thursday when we bust out the stray again.
Haruka-san
did? Okay. What is happening? I want to know. Okay, the choice here is to say that we understand. Because we want to know more, right? I really like her. I don't know. She has such a cool vibe. And she's super cute. Well then, excuse me. I left the dorm head's room. Hope they can participate Thursday. Aww. Well, I appreciate the feeling, even if you manage not to in the end, you know. It depends, you know. Life takes precedence, things happen. It's all good. We will feel you in spirit. For sure. I was feeling tense already, but I figured it would be fine if I just dropped off the report. Still, I was interested in what was going on with Haruka-san too. I can't believe she's just harmlessly attending their meeting. For the moment, I just headed toward the unused classroom. Ah, it's occupied now. The normally silent classroom was now loud with a crowd of voices. I peeked in from the back door and it looked like they were in the middle of a debate. What was I supposed to do? I didn't want to interrupt the meeting. The cause for my small outburst was Haruka-san. She pulled me into one of the seats at the back of the classroom. What are you doing? Okay. Okay, even so, this is still... Wait, so she's preparing to launch an offensive? I facepalmed. I didn't know what to say. The prefect slammed her hand onto the blackboard. You can wear the headset for the into root as well. Okay. I guess that's a good idea. It was a familiar looking scene. That is, it was one I'd seen on those police shows, where they post up all the usual suspects on the board to figure out the culprit. The explanation continued. The prefect proposed something like a regular patrol around the vending machine outside, due to a particular mischievous student. Since I had been there too at the time of the incident, that didn't sit well with me. Haruka-san, let's get out of here. Just as I was about to stop her, Haruka-san bolted up. Ooh! There was a stir among the prefects. Haruka-san... Futaki-san, standing up from the very front seat, turned to look back at us. Haruka-san's body stiffened.
Haruka-san's confidence withered away, in stark contrast with the coldness Futaki-san addressed her with. Haruka-san hit her palm on the desk twice.
あなたは疑われてもしょうがないものね。普段が普段、いつもがいつもだし。やってもいないこと吹聴するのは不正義ですらあると思うよ。不正義？
Futaki-san let out a little mocking laugh.
そういう言葉はもっと真面目でルールを守る人間が言うべきよ。簡単なことでしょ。周りに迷惑をかけない。 きちんと秩序を保って規則を守る。たとえそうしていても目の敵にする癖に。それはあなたしだいよ。ナオエリキ？あなたもそう思うでしょ？リキ君は関係ないでしょ！関係大いにありよ。だいたいあなたたちの評判をそれ以上落としてどうするの？普段からいろいろ騒がしいあなたたちなのだし、クルガヤさんたちも迷惑だと思ってるんじゃないかしら。
You like the voices. It reminds you of Kanokon. I don't think I know that.
Yuine wa sonna koto iwanai. Daichi, ima wa watashi no hanashi de Riki-kun ya Yuine wa kankei nai!
I don't remember where Kurugaya would have complained about this. Doesn't Kurugaya like Haruka? Like, I don't... That kind of like doesn't fit there for me.
Kankei nai to omotte iru no wa anata dake yo. Saigusa Haruka. 放課後よく一緒にいるらしいじゃない。あまり見せつけられても困るわね。不純異性交友で指導室行きになっても知らないわよ。あなたが誘ったのか、彼が乗ったのか知らないけど。The
eyes of all the prefects in the room, some underclassmen among them of course, felt as painful as needles. I could hear them whispering. Suggestive glances were exchanged. They were all looking at me with faces mixed with contempt.
なにをいきなり。そんなゲスなかんぐりをするなんて、性格歪んでるんじゃないの。どっちに対するものがゲスなかんぐりなのかしら。彼のこと。それともあなた自身のこと。でも、サイグサハルカが悪いに決まってるんだけどね。あなたはごく潰しのろくでなし。役立たずだものね。
What a, with a jerk. Excuse me. But actually, what a jerk also fits. So that's why my mind went there immediately. With a jerk, Haruka-san's left fist drew back.
あなたが悪いのよ。黙れ。あなたがいなければ問題ないのよ。
Takesoru, yeah, she is being very mean.
黙れ。あなたが。 黙れ!
Haruka-san... Haruka-san suddenly threw over the desk. The loud noise echoed around the room. The classroom erupted. Kicking at the desk, Haruka-san made a grab for the nearest prefect. Haruka-san, you can't! Stop it! Panicked, I held Haruka-san back from behind. But she was violently flailing around with her arms and legs. Just like a child throwing a tantrum. In a twinkling, the room was resounding with cries and yells. After it was over, we were put on cleaning duty. Haruka-san muttered, a rag hanging limply in one hand. Nah, it's fine. Even though I said that my body was covered in scratches and bruises. I hurt all over and my right cheek and spine were aching. I can't even remember how many punches and kicks I'd taken. Haruka-san repeated herself. I understand why you're upset. With all those accusations. But freaking out like that is still wrong. Even so, it was Taki-san that had pushed her to it. Even before I had come to back her up, she had kept kindling Haruka-san's flame. At the very least, Haruka-san's cheerful troublemaker image had been shattered completely. Haruka-san merely hung her head dejectedly and didn't respond. Haruka-san, you're acting strange. Normally, you'd make a comeback at that. To be sure, Haruka-san had caused her fair share of disturbances. She was just a goofy joker who loved funny and strange stuff. If you compare that fight with the prefects with her earlier stuff, the difference was just too striking. Something wasn't right, I thought.
Kishimono.
Huh?
Ega kishimono. Umaku ikanai no. Dakara tanoshiku nai no. Itsumo nara tanoshii no. Itsumo nara tsuraku nai no. Itsumo nara. Ryū wa wakatteru nda. Kitto sou ni chigai nai nda.
You're talking about Futaki-san? Haruka-san spit the words out.
Futaki-san.
We're done with all of it. I put a reassuring hand on Haruka-san's back. We're done, so may we return to the dorms?
もちろん。これに懲りたら余計な主張なんかしないことね。隅っこで邪魔にならないようにおとなしくしてなさい。サイグサ・ハルカ。あなたにはそれがお似合いなんだから。
As if remembering something at that point, Futaki-san quirked her lips a little.
整備委員会だっけ? 役立たずのね。
What are you trying to say?
執行部以下の委員会。全部言える?
Wait, all of them? Startled by the sudden question, I started ticking them off on my fingers. The library committee, culture committee, health committee, sports committee, culture association. Other than that, the broadcast committee and the housing committee.
Eh? この春に風紀委員会に統合されたのよ。だから、ないの、今は。
Futaki-san didn't look at Haruka-san as she spoke, only at me.
知ってた?
No, I didn't.
そんなものよね。委員会活動はしてない人には分からないものだし。
I'm sorry, I'm doing my best to just hold it together. But I really, really don't like her. Or let's not say don't like her, just don't like her attitude and her words and everything that she's been doing and saying. Maybe that doesn't equate with her person, but that's all I've seen of her, and I don't like it. Ah! Okay, okay, let's go.
だから、サイグサ・ハルカ。役立たずは引っ込んでなさい。暴れて机をいくつも壊して、自分で壊したそれを自分で直すつもりなの?馬鹿らしい。 最低ね。
Haruka-san's left fist trembled visibly.
大事なお友達にも教えなかったのよね。どう? この子の空回りっぷり、面白いでしょ?
I can hate her for now, thank you.
自分が… ん? 自分が潰したくせに! 生徒会に根回しして潰したくせに! 潰した?
Wait. She finds that choice of wording offensive? Given all of the choices of wording she herself has made? I have no words. Let's keep going.
休眠状態だった委員会の仕事も積極的に引き受けた結果なんだから。
Her words were kind on the surface, but her voice was steeped in sarcasm.
この子に何を言われたかわからないけど
所詮は自分のわがままが通らなくて暴れてるだけなんだから。じゃあね。
Futaki-san left. Haruka-san.
ごめん、リキ君。一人にして。
But Haruka-san.
一人にして。
Alright. Haruka-san hung her head, shoulders trembling. I saw no option but to do as she had told me.At the entrance to the dorms, I ran into Futaki-san. Was she out on patrol? Well, she didn't have any of the other prefects with her. She was twirling a ballpoint pen around in her right hand. Is she waiting for someone? Nah, probably not. I didn't look at her, simply continuing to walk my way.
ちょっと話があるんだけど。
Oh god, what do you want? Ignore, ignore, yes, 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 Ricky!
呼んでるのに無視するなんてひどいと思わない?
I'm pretty sure you've done some cruel things too. Just like a bully.
人でなしね。
Futaki-san shrugged. She slipped the ballpoint pen into her pocket with a sigh.
そうね。その通りね。あなたにそう言われるのはもう慣れたわ。まあ。
What was going on? I wasn't sensing any hostility in her words today. You had something to talk with me about? Futaki-san looked at me. Her glance was as piercing as a bullet.
あなたは幸福が投了だと思う?
I had no idea what she was suddenly talking about.
世界にある幸と不幸は総量が決まっているとする。誰かが幸福になれば誰かが不幸になるゲーム。
Not really, no. I wouldn't say so. I don't think it works like that, yeah.
そうかしら。プラスとマイナスがぐるぐる回ってゼロに戻ってくるゲーム。
Life is not a zero-sum game. Come on, lady.
なかなか面白くできてると思わない?世間の構造としては。
Well, if that were true, I'd say that the ratio of sadness in the world is a little unbalanced. Someone's unhappiness is another's happiness. If you think of it that way, would you even stop wishing for the happiness of those dear to you?
そうね。確かにそうね。
After that answer, Futaki-san fell silent.It was hard to tell what she was thinking from her expressionless face, but it seemed like she was hesitating about something. That's what you wanted to ask me?
それだけよ。ま、せいぜい頑張ることね。
Do my best at what? Futaki-san gave a small shrug.
たまには話してみるものね。有意義だったわ。
I don't understand. Okay. Having said that, Futaki-san spun on her heel and headed off toward the female dorm. What was that? I had no idea what she was talking about. I shook my head. One day followed another without Haruka-san popping in the classroom before the first bell. Something must still be going on. That piqued my curiosity, so I ventured out into the corridor. Hi. Soon I found the back of a figure trudging down the hallway. Haruka-san? Looking at the slump of Haruka-san's back, I could tell she wasn't in good spirits. But the Haruka-san that turned to look back at me seemed the same as ever.
Ohayo. Dou ka shita no?
Morning. You didn't come to the classroom, so I was wondering if something was up. Were you late again today? Is the alarm clock not working or something?
Chikoku wa shite nai desu yo. Kyou mo genki ippai!幸せいっぱいでファイト。
モノトーン。
こまりちゃんみたいにはなれないね。私実は寮でも監視されてたりする毎日なのです。
Wait, what? Observation?
おとなしくしてないとすごく怒られるんだけど、やることないとさつまらなくてさ、怒られるのも嫌だから。今はおとなしくしてる。なかなか頑張ってるのですよ。でも信頼ないからな、私。困ったものだね。
Haruka-san stuck her left hand into the pocket of her uniform. There was a rattling sound. She pulled her hand out of the pocket, rubbing a few marbles between her fingers.
次、移動教室だし、行くね。
Yeah, Haruka-san just...
何?そんな顔しないで。私は大丈夫だよ。大丈夫大丈夫。毎回毎回いろいろ慣れっこだからさ。今回も大丈夫。これでおしまいだろうから。ひょっとして 私のことが心配?
Yes, I am.
どうして?
Why? Why indeed? At that moment, I couldn't find the words.
冗談だよ。
Haruka-san replied morosely.
困らせてごめんね。
She turned away, and then the school bell rang. I had to get back to my own class. On my way back, I paused. In the corner of the hallway, I caught a glimpse of something sparkling. What is that? Faster than I could get there, a girl who had been collecting pins out of the nearby bulletin board stooped to retrieve it. It was Teki-san. What she had picked up looked like a marble. Rolling the marble between her thumb and index finger, Teki-san seemed deep in thought. Her face looked a little strange. Her expression was one of vexation, mixed with uncertainty. Teki-san?
何?
She seemed to have caught my murmur as Teki-san walked over to
何
か
用? Me. 何か用?
No, not really. She was still toying with the marble. Its color seemed like a light purplish red. That's one of Haruka-san's?
そうかもしれないわね。何?
I was caught off balance by her gentle tone. So vastly different from the usual. It's nothing.
懐かしいわね。
Teki-san dropped the marble in her pocket as she murmured that. Memories of what? You used to play with marbles? Without answering my question, she stuck her right hand into her pocket. There was a crinkling noise, like paper being crumbled.
ばらまかれて大変だったのよ。
She must be talking about the chase scene.
多分、最初は面白半分のそれが、あっという間に広がった。
You mean the marble business has caught on?
女子寮で流行ったのよ。困ったものね。じゃあね。
Teki-san walked off with a shrug. I shook my head at her strange mood as I watched her walk away. Then I took a look at the bulletin board she'd been working on. There were the usual posters saying stuff like, Home Economic Club is looking for members, join us, and ads for sports teams and such. There was just one corner of the board that was strangely empty. It looked like someone had torn something off in a hurry, judging from the small scraps that looked like newspaper left behind under the thumbtacks. This isn't like Teki-san. That seemed just the kind of thing she'd normally make certain was clean and proper. I pulled out the thumbtacks, gathering up the scraps of paper, rolled them up and tossed them into a nearby trash bin. On our way back from the special classroom wing, Masato was swaying unsteadily on his feet. I had been spacing out during class, and the teacher had slapped me with the supplementary exam. I accidentally got Masato dragged into it as well. Oh no. I think you'd still die. Anyway, sorry about that, getting you involved and all.
いいけどよ。珍しいな、授業中にリキがぼーっとしてるなんてよ。
は?There was something in my shoe locker. It looked like a sheet of copy paper. The paper was folded, so I opened it up.
なんだ? どうした? 新聞のコピーじゃねえか?
It was an enlarged version of the local news section.
書き込みがあるな。教室に来られたし。ってなんだこりゃ?
Sorry, Masato. Could you take my bag?
おいいけど。けおい、リキ、どこ行くんだ?
I was already running off.I stood in front of the blackboard. There were several short phrases scribbled all over it in thick chalk. Haruka-san's name was scrawled there in large letters, and around it were horrible things written in color. I then found sheets of copy paper scattered on the floor. Are the ones on the floor the same as this one? I pulled a note from my shoe locker out of my pocket for comparison.It was the same as the one I picked up off the floor. Relative arrested for unlawful assault. Also charged with breaking and entering. A crime of revenge? The uneasy voices of the neighborhood. In the early dawn, a man entered his relative's home unpermitted and assaulted them. Case result. Defendant sentenced to serve in prison. The name of the defendant...There was a bright red circle drawn violently around the name. the part that said Saigu-san. My head snapped up. In a panic, I looked into the next classroom. I slammed the door open and saw that it was exactly like the one I'd just left. Who? And the next classroom. Who would... And the next classroom after that. The same. That libel was spread throughout the entire school. I went back to the classroom I had first been called out to. I looked over the classroom. No one's here. Where's Haruka-san? I walked up toward the teacher's desk at the front of the class. What? I stumbled. Haruka-san? Haruka-san was sitting there hugging her knees. Her face was buried in her knees, so I couldn't make out her expression. Seeing her like that, I didn't know how to start the conversation. Huh? I suddenly heard her voice. Why are you apologizing, Haruka-san? Haruka-san's voice leaked out as she bit her lip. Unable to say anything but that, Haruka-san sobbed with her face cast down. I stood in front of her as she continued to cry. I went and erased the blackboard and picked up the papers scattered on the floor. Then I went to the next class and did the same. There were even flyers thrust into the desks in the classrooms. Who would do something like this? I muttered. Oh. I heard a sudden voice, a reassuring voice. Kyosuke's here. Kyosuke. Kyosuke was holding a sheet of paper under his arm. A sheaf of papers. So you saw them too?
Ah.
Kyosuke nodded. Did you erase the blackboards too?
Ah, 全部 消した. Saigu-san.
She's in that classroom. She keeps crying and I don't know what to say to her. Well, for now we should finish cleaning up this mess.
そうだな.
Thanks, Kyosuke.
礼はいらないぞ, Riki. だが...
Kyosuke handed me the heap of papers.
明日には噂は広がってるだろうな.
What should we do? It's impossible to keep people from talking. Kyosuke was right. This topic was probably going to be all over the school by tomorrow.
Saigu-san,を寮に送ってやれ. 今日はもうどうしようもない.
Yeah. I nodded. Haruka-san. Haruka-san wasn't crying anymore. Haruka-san. I stooped down beside her. There was a somehow wild and terrified look in Haruka-san's eyes. Come on, let's get you back to your dorm. I'll take you. When I reached out my hand to her, Haruka-san gave a start. Come on, let's go. She shook her head mutely, back and forth. You don't want to go back? She nodded once. But you can't stay here forever. Haruka-san turned away from me a little and pressed her face into her knees. As she did, she shook her head. Come on now, Haruka-san, stand up. She ignored me, still refusing to budge. This was a problem. Well, whatever. I lowered myself down next to her. Haruka-san asked something in a voice husky from crying. You're asking me why again, Haruka-san? I silently sat next to her. The words left Haruka-san's mouth in a flat, defeated tone. Of course I don't hate you. You're you, that's all. I wondered if what she was saying meant the things written on those flyers were true. I wouldn't hate you just because of something like that. No one else would either. Not Kyosuke, Kengo, Masato, or Jin. That was about your dad, wasn't it? As I said, that something occurred to me. Hang on. Did that mean the person I met at Haruka-san's house was the person from the news item? Your other father? I was taken aback by that. It seemed that the Saigusa family used to be major landowners. They had lost most of it during the post-war rezoning, ending up with nothing but small mountain plots and rice fields.
生活はひどかったんだって。でも昔からいい暮らしをしてた細草の家の人間はプライドだけ高くてね。どうしたら惨めな自分たちが救われるかって考えたんだって。それで小さな祭場を作ったの。山に最もらしい小さな社があったから何もなかったから自分たちの血をあがめることにしたんだって。
After that, the family managed to pull itself together, but somehow they became obsessed with blood. There were a lot of short-lived people among them, so they made a rule to protect their blood. A rule?
子孫が耐えてはダメだからって。一族の娘にお婿さんを二人当てがうことにしたの。
Oh my god, what?
なんというか… 時代錯誤もいいところ笑っちゃうよ。でも笑えないのは私たちがそうしてできた子供だってことなんだ。We?
Haruka-san, you have siblings. Wait, no way.
そうだよ。リキ君が今考えた通り。
You just have to put two and two together, I mean.
二木彼方は片割れ。双子の片割れなんだ。 私たちの母親にもお婿さんが二人のはずだった。でもそれに納得できなかったお婿さんの一人が事件を起こした。私は細草翔という名前と顔写真だけしか知らない。リキ君が会ったことのある男の人は後から本家に連れてこられた人で、細草翔は不満だったんだと思う。 その結果、細草翔は家に押し入ったの。
Caught up in that strange family situation, I'm sure it was only natural for ugly feelings to fester among the adults.
細草の家のメンツは丸つぶれだった。地元の名士で通るところまで持ち直したのに、それをぶち壊されて。でも、母親は一族の直系だった。子供だけ残して。
What shocked the family wasn't that there were twins, but that each girl bore the genes of a different man. Is that even possible?
わかりやすく言うとね、父親違いの双子なんだって。ただの二卵性双生児は父親と母親が一緒。でも、 私たちは違った。それで親族会議で細草翔の子供ではない子供を引き取ることにした。でもね、うちの親たちはその時には感動の上追放されて行方不明。どちらがそうなのかわからなかった。You
don't know either, Haruka-san? Interesting family rules. Yeah, you don't say. I am a trying my best to hold back the level to which I am appalled. Haruka-san shook her head in response to my question. Well, it's only natural for families to compare their children on some level, but the way Haruka-san put it made it sound more like they were scrutinizing every little thing the two did. Like, which one started talking first? Kanata already knows a whole bushel of words, doesn't she? Which one started walking first? Oh, Kanata, you're already walking everywhere, aren't you? Such an energetic child. Which was easier to train? Your sitting posture is just perfect, isn't it, Kanata? Which was smarter? You can already read books? You're such a smart child, Kanata. Which was healthier? Little Kanata, even though the darling had a little fever, she still placed first in the park foot race. Oh man, that's not a way to live life. Haruka-san hung her head. Haruka-san, Kanata had been raised by the Fukis, a branch family. So now the ones running the Saigusa family were the Futakis.
I was a daughter of the Saigusa Shou's daughter. That's how I was decided. After that, I was like a blind Saigusa. Saigusa's bad luck, a poor daughter, not doing well at the business, it was my fault. I was fighting in the shadows, it was my fault. 泥水に顔を押し付けられたまま謝罪を叫ばされたこともあったよ。What?
I have read this phrase 3 times and I'm still not sure that I completely grasp it. What?
ごめんなさい、ごめんなさい、迷惑かけてごめんなさい。私のせいです、ごめんなさい、ごめんなさい、全部私のせいです、ごめんなさい、ごめんなさい。 謝罪を神様が聞いてくれたら泥水が<笑>いるわけないのに。どこにも神様なんているわけないのに。酒になったかって何度も聞くんだよ。何度も何度も何度も。バカじゃないの。バカバカしい。
Yeah, no, you don't say. She went on like a broken radio. Each word was permeated with deep-seated resentment.
Oh,
God.
I was able to help. 気を使って失敗したら殴られて。それも神様が決めたんだって。おかしいよね。おかしな神様。そんな神様なんているわけがない。
I couldn't tell what kind of face Haruka-san was making as she continued to hang her head as she spoke. She just went on talking about her days spent in misery. There was a pause, and then Haruka-san's tone changed.
あれは久しぶりに晴れた朝のことだった。学園に入る少し前だったかな。あいつがあの二人の親を探し出した。リキ君もあった。あの二人の親が私をサイグサの家から連れ出して一緒に住むようになったんだ。あいつの差し金なんだって聞かされた。あいつは私に同情したんだって。 かわいそうだからそうしてあげたんだって。でもね、違うの。そんな理由じゃないの。私がいるから。私のせいで、サイグサの家が悪く言われるから。あいつも私をいじめたいだけなんだ。いじめの私を笑うために連れてきたに決まってる。だから、私は。Haruka-san
reached out her left hand. She gripped the collar of my shirt tightly. She squeezed so hard her fingers turned white from the pressure. Haruka-san raised her head. Her face was a mask of untempered fury. Her eyes were narrowed into a glare, their corners glittering with wetness.
Haruka-san?
With moist eyes, she spoke as if she was forcing out the dregs from the deepest reaches of her heart. I know this is maybe not the moment, but I think I just now see the little details here on her hair clips. They're like little, I don't know,
Little flowers, crosses, I don't know, I think maybe they're flowers with four petals or something. Cute, but yikes, Jesus.
あいつをあがめるバカな大人たちを笑いたかったの。私のすること、私のしたこと、私がダメになればなるほど、あいつもダメになる。そうでしょ?だって母親は一緒なんだもの。半分一緒なんだもの。何もかもあいつと違うことをしたかったの。優等生ぶったかっちり固まった真面目なあいつを貶めたかったの。 いつもイラついてるあいつを見るのは楽しかった。本当に楽しかった。毎週報告が行くの。きっと苦々しい顔した大人たちがあいつに説教をするんだ。お前の監督がなっていない。お前がいてなんたるざまだ。お前はあれとは違うのだ。いい君。<笑>偉そうにしている癖に。縛られたままなの。バカなあの大人たちに。でも私は自由だから。
Haruka-san continued while laughing.
ずっと楽しいことしてたのに。あいつが今になって私に与えたものが欲しくなった。
I heard the sound of her teeth grinding. Tears were dribbling down Haruka-san's face as she talked about how horrible Futaki-san was. Haruka-san clenched her head with both hands.
サイグサの家と同じことされるの嫌だ。痛いのは嫌。辛いのは嫌。苦しいのもひもじいのも悲しいのも嫌。でも、もっと嫌なのは、私が言っちゃいけないって言われるのが一番嫌。私に、私には、私には、居場所なんかどこにもないのに、この居場所をなくすなんて嫌だ。
Haruka-san began to tremble violently. My breath caught. A shiver ran down my spine. Haruka-san's eyes were strange, empty. With eyes like that, she was making a queer expression, crying and smiling at the same time.
I'm a girl.
Haruka-san. While repeating these things, Haruka-san strongly grasped my arm. Her fingers sank into the flesh of my skin. I was so caught up in the moment I couldn't feel a thing. Haruka-san. Haruka-san's hand was shaking as she held me in her grip. I could see it in my mind's eye, looking up, seeing those tall, dark forms all around you. Hearing the voices of those tall, dark forms, voices that compared you to someone else, turning into voices of rejection. How could someone who had, since birth, been surrounded by that, go on living? Haruka-san's face distorted, as though
disgorging the sediment built up inside her heart. She shouted out her resentment at someone who wasn't there. Haruka-san! I seized Haruka-san's shoulders. I shook her by her shoulders. Again and again, I shook her. I shouted at Haruka-san, who was sobbing convulsively. You can't say that. A spark of light returned to Haruka-san's eyes. You can't say that. Haruka-san shot back that question in a childlike voice. Because that's a horrible thing to say. There's nothing fun or happy about it. Haruka-san's fingers trembled. A person rejecting themselves. If that happens, it's all over, isn't it? That's why you can't say it. I don't want you to ever, ever say that. I wonder if I had once heard those words from someone. It might have been Kyosuke or perhaps someone else. Please promise me you won't say it again. Haruka-san, promise me. Say you'll never say it again. Haruka-san's lips soundlessly mouthed another why. Why? Right. Why? Why did I want her to make that promise? Why did I need that promise so badly? I see. It's because I like you, Haruka-san. That's all. Your past has nothing to do with it. My heart revolved against Futaki-san's warnings. Yeah, I know, me too, right? I'm doing my best to hold it together. I couldn't stand anyone saying I should reject this girl named Haruka Saigusa. I like you, Haruka-san. Anyone. Anyone would be angry were the girl they like being spoken badly of. Haruka-san began to cry in intermittent sobs again. Since she was in no state to go back to the dorm, I ended up walking Haruka-san all the way to her house. Yeah, I'll figure something out. Thanks to Kyosuke, I'm used to this kind of thing after all. Haruka-san nodded with eyes puffed and red from crying. I looked up at her house. It was pitch dark inside. They're probably at work, Haruka-san added.
Oyasumi, Riki-kun. Ah, seifuku beto-beto ni shite gomen ne.
It's no problem. Something like that.
Gomen.
Rather than sorry, I'd rather you say thanks. Haruka-san gave a small laugh. She's finally smiling again.
Arigato, Riki-kun. Kansha shimasu yo.
Making a sweep with her left hand, Haruka-san bowed her head in a formal gesture. So Kanata sent Haruka away from the abusive main family to their mother, and Haruka's been trying to take revenge on her all this time as a thank you, even though Kanata has to live with them now and Haruka's free to do whatever. I don't know. If you take it that way, sure, you can see it like that, but my problem is not necessarily with Kanata's actions in regards to that, but with the way she is acting. Because, like, what I've seen so far is just she's being vicious, like, more than just a bully, just absolutely... I don't know. I don't even have words to describe. I have a very visceral reaction in my body every time she says something directly to Haruka. And sure, you can spin it like Haruka's been trying to do all of these things against Kanata as well. And so Kanata maybe is fighting back. But that doesn't sound right. I don't think that's the proper way to frame this. It has deeper meanings and complexities, and sure, maybe there is a part of Haruka that is taking it
out on Kanata without it being Kanata's fault. But excuse me, Kanata has not been a stellar human being either, at least from what we see so far. So Kanata is very clearly in the wrong. She truly believes the happiness thing at this point. That if she is to be happy, Haruka has to be sad. Yeah, that part really upset me about her. Like the world being a zero-sum game. But in a way, maybe we cannot hold it against her. Maybe it's a philosophy that has been instilled in her by the way she was raised. And so all of those ideas kind of are starting to, you know, form and take shape out of the background of everything that she has been through and the type of ideas that others have instilled in her. So it's not directly her fault. It's not like she has a larger, more expansive view of the world outside of this toxic environment, after all, that she's been raised in, and then she still chooses to believe these things. So she is a victim in a sense too. I will acknowledge that. It's just, why is she being not hostile, more or less, all right? I wouldn't go as far as say nice. I don't think it's necessarily nice, but she is not vicious behind Haruka's back, but directly to Haruka, she just throws everything that she has at her. In a way, metaphorically, it's like every time she gets a chance, she takes Haruka and pushes her into that mud water and asks her, oh, has it turned into sake just yet? It's basically a repetition of that, but obviously on a metaphorical level, not an actual literal level. It's weird, but I guess we need to go more into the story to understand. It shapes your soul too. Yeah. So I get it, but to a certain extent, if she is so smart, if she has read so many books and like knows so much about the world, why can't she grow out of it and snap out of it just a tiny bit to try and piece together that the things that have been instilled in her since she was a child are not entirely correct? And yeah, the whole thing with the zero-sum game of happiness and sadness really like, I don't know, settled it for me. Something about her must be triggering her. Yeah, I mean, they are both triggering each other. That is true. I'm not contesting that in any way. And I am not defending Haruka in the sense that Haruka is absolutely in the right to act and do what the way she is acting and the choices she is making. But like, neither of them are being fully the higher person here. They're both making their own mistakes. And in some capacity, they're probably taking out on each other the things that their environment made them frustrated about, without it actually being the other's fault. Long time since I saw a game that have so deep and strong characteristic, and I'm only an hour in. Well, should we recommend the rest of Little Busters to you? I'm sure Beatrice can campaign for it. In the chat. Yeah, we have been doing Little Busters for a while. It has a lot of content to offer, plenty of characters with their own roots, and this is just one of them. And I guess it's cool to have Clinton around so that he can actually catch a little bit of this, because before you've just seen the baseball and the joking around kind of bits and not the deep bits. Yeah, I guess there's a bit more to uncover here until things are clarified. Oof. Making a sweep with her left hand, Haruka-san bowed her head in a formal gesture. Right, well, see you tomorrow. Haruka-san's expression grew cloudy. Tomorrow, are you going to skip? Haruka-san hesitated a little. Haruka-san reached her arms out tentatively.
As she embraced me lightly, Haruka-san looked down. Haruka-san.
また明日。でいいよ。リキ君がいてくれれば。
Oh, that's so sweet. This stuff works better for me. Okay, Clinton, cool. Long time ago, I saw an anime while browsing that had the same name. Is this the same story? Well, if you saw the Little Busters anime, yes, it's based on this. But obviously, when you take a visual novel that has branching storylines and like alternative routes depending on which heroine you're picking and so on and the choices that you're making, obviously that cannot be properly conveyed to a anime series which is supposed to just be linear. So, overall, the sentiment about the adaptation is not incredibly positive. Because they had to skip a lot and cut corners and stuff, so yeah, I did watch the anime and to me it was alright, but I always wanted more because people were really praising the visual novel, so I guess here I am doing the visual novel some decade down the line. I don't remember which year the anime was from. It was a long time ago. Yeah, so Little Buster is super hard to properly adapt. Yeah. Yeah. That is very true. Maybe some other visual novels lend themselves a little bit better. But for this, it's very difficult to include everyone properly. Especially, as I said, like, when you do it in an anime, it cannot have... Okay, and in this episode, the main character is actually interested in this girl, but in the next episode, he's interested in none. You know, it doesn't work. It doesn't work. Anime's bad though, there you go, confirmation. Sansuke, for example, isn't too bad, but Little Busters and Umineko are very hard. Yeah. Yeah, for Sansuke, the other routes were just a little bit of extra content. A little bit of, you know, let's see the characters a little bit more in depth. A bit of a, like, a what if. But obviously the meat of the story was the main route that you follow. So yeah, here it's every heroine gets her own time to shine and a very robust and complex story, so even though you know that maybe Rin is supposed to be the main girl, it's hard to differentiate and distinguish because they're all so well fleshed out, and at the same time the roots being so disparate, maybe I'm not saying the right word, but so unconnected, it's hard to then collect it together and put it into something that makes sense. So, yeah. Stansky side routes are all bad. Oh, I enjoyed them. I really did. Obviously, they were not supposed to be the main content. Clearly. But I liked that. I liked seeing more of the characters. Suzuha route is great. Yes, Suzuha is absolute love. Yes, disparate. That's what I was trying to say. Maybe I'm not pronouncing it right. I'm sorry. I have trouble with that. As a person who has spent a lot of time just reading English without hearing it said out loud, sometimes I realize that there are words I know that I have only read and never heard out loud. And my mind kind of like made its own resolution or conclusion on what it maybe should sound like, but I never really confirmed it. And then when I read it out loud, I'm like, oh, wait, this is one of those words, huh, isn't it? I said it correct? Okay, well, that feels good to know. Thank you. With a small sigh, Haruka-san withdrew her hands from my chest and stepped away, raising her head. Her twin tails danced gently. There was a faint scent of citrus trailing after her.
おやすみなさい.
Leaving me with a final goodbye, Haruka-san went into her house. Good night, Haruka-san. I decided to get back to the dorms myself. When homeroom ended, Masato and Kengo came straight to my seat. Masato, Kengo, what's up?
噂知ってるか, Riki?
So you guys have heard it too. Kengo silently nodded. Did you hear from Kyosuke?
いや、別口だ。そこら中で三枝のことが噂になってる。クラスの連中もな。
Glancing over to where his chin was pointing, I found a group of students whispering together. They averted their eyes when they saw me looking. I see.
もともとがもともとだからな、三枝は。
マサト。
わかってるよ。怖い顔すんなって。
But it looks like the stuff in the pamphlets was true.
そうか。
With that, we sank into silence. To be honest, right now I'm blanking out on what you're mentioning, Beatrice. I just remember I really enjoyed exploring extra content about each of the characters, and Suzuha is just absolutely, absolutely stunning, and I love her. I love seeing more of her. I don't remember that moment. Probably did not commit it to memory. I'm not saying that everything about the roots is absolutely stellar. But yeah.
Kumi no anoko desho? Dousan ga ne? Datte... Yappari ne? Desho?
Like, what right do you have to hear stuff about someone's relatives? Not even that person themselves. And then shun the person and just talk behind their backs and be like, oh my god, their dad did that. Did you hear? Oh my god. What is that? Just go on with your life. Let people be. Fuck off. Sorry, I had to say it. Oh, it's so annoying to me. I can't get it. I don't get it. Where are all of these coming from? Jesus Christ. It seems rumors were evolving, with people adding whatever macabre details to make the story more interesting or bizarre. I mean, Okabe had his moments where I think we can all understand that he wasn't in the best of spirits because, yeah. He had a lot to take on his back, so. Not saying I like it, just saying I'm not judging him too harshly. I wanted to cover my ears. How was Haruka-san taking this? As I thought about that, my anger flamed toward the ones responsible for spreading the flyers.
Riki.
Please don't say anything, Masato.
Kedo yo.
There was a loud noise. Someone stood up. It was the head prefect. Taki-san had a severe expression on her face. In an instant, the cafeteria fell silent. As Taki-san said nothing, the normal commotion soon resumed.
Nanka areten na, Futaki mo.
Musekinin na uwasa de mochikiri dakara darou na.
Ah? Nande sore?
Futaki ga Saigusa o me no kataki ni suru no wa shimai dakara da tteiu uwasa da.
Honto ka yo sore? Tte Kyosuke.
Kyosuke looked down at me, standing there, sucking on a small carton of milk.
Nantonaku niteru shi na, futari tomo.
Shouko wa aru no ka yo?
Nai. Dakara futaki mo iradatteru tte toko daro.
Kyosuke was looking intently at me. What, Kyosuke?
Nandemo nai.
I'm just gonna stare her down, but it's nothing. Okay. I was probably the only one who knew for a fact they really were sisters. As I set aside my chopsticks, I thought that silently in my mind. After lunch, I made my way to the courtyard, where I found Haruka-san and Futaki-san in the middle of a fight.
Nasai, Saigusa Haruka! Nashi o saigo made! Anta no hanashi nanka kikitaku nai! Machinasai!
Futaki-san grabbed Haruka-san's arm.
Nani?
Taki-san stiffened as she grasped Haruka-san.
Hanashi wa tada tori gakatta dake nan desu kedo ne.
Haruka-san spoke spitefully over her shoulder.
兄弟だって言いふらしてるのはあなたなの。は、何？そんなの知らない。やめなさい。もしあなたならばだけれど。私じゃないよ。自然に出たんじゃないの。サイグザ・ハルカ。あなたのやっていることは愚かなことなのよ。はいはい、そうですね。私はバカで愚かなのでしょうがないんですよ。
は
あ、もうあなたがバカだなんて言ってないでしょ。
Peki-san's attitude held none of its usual sharpness. If anything, her tone was soft and appealing.
知ってる。その噂はあなたの心象をさらに悪くしてる。他人に噂の矛先を向けさせようとしてるって言われてるのよ。
委員長様はみんなから慕われてるようでよかったね。
ハル、いえ、サイグザ・ハルカ。指導室へ放課後来なさい。先生方が聞きたいことがあるって。
Haruka-san's face paled.
話すことなんて何もない。
いいわね、伝えたから
手を回したんだ。あんたはそういう方法ばっかり使う。わかった。行けばいいんでしょ、行けば。
Haruka-san squared her shoulders and stalked off toward the school building. Futaki-san.
ねえ、あなたはどう思う？困ったことになったと思わないかしら？
Didn't you bring this on yourself?
サイグサ・ハルカは支えを見つけたのかしらね。
Taki-san ignored my question. Then suddenly she fixed me with her gaze.
おせっかいな人ね、あの子。そのうち潰れるわよ。
Aren't you the one that's aiming to do that?
あなたにはそう見える。
Anyone would think that, wouldn't you say?You're trying to chase her out of the school. The corners of Taki-san's lips quirked.
逆よ。
What?
私がやっているのは逆。全くの逆。潰すために追い出そうとしているわけじゃないの。こうでもしないとあの子、潰れちゃうから。
Are you trying to tell me you're chasing her out is a good deed?
そうね。そちらの方が幸福じゃないのかしら。次こそ。次こそは、サイグサハルカの居場所も見つかるでしょう。
You really are a bully.
知ってる。
I mean, why have you decided this on her, in her place? And, you know, like, she gets no say in that? Maybe she just likes it here. Taki-san nodded, like she liked that fucking bench. Jesus.
私は人でなしだわ。あなたに何度も言われた通りね。人でなしだから。何でもする。でも、ナオエリキ、あなたが悪いんだからね。その意味で、私はあなたが嫌い。
I'm not crazy about you either.
あら、相性がいいわね。サイグサハルカを構うのなんかやめて、私と付き合わない。
No thanks.
あらら、振られちゃった。
Am I seeing a deja vu from Mio's root? Oh dear. Futaki-san laughed through her nose.
では、昇進の女の子は退場するとしますか?
Who's the heartbroken one here?
もちろん私よ。決まってるでしょ。
Expressionless as always, Futaki-san left after those words. Ay, ay, ay. On the weekend, I decided to go along with Haruka-san as she made her usual trip.
無理に付き合わなくていいんだよ、リキ君。
It's no problem. The one who's having to force herself here is obviously Haruka-san. We headed for the Saigusa home. The spotless dining room. The sparklingly new, neatly arranged cooking utensils. The brand new looking tablecloth. I already knew that the whole set was a recent acquisition rather than something accumulated naturally over the years.
またお会いできて嬉しいわ、ナオエさん。ねえ、ハルカ。今晩も付き合ってくれてありがとう。おかわりはどうですか？
Yes, please.
どんどん食べていいからね。
Thank you. I carried some rice to my mouth with my chopsticks. Just like before, I couldn't really taste anything.
そういえば、はるか、最近学園の方はどう？
テストが終わっても気を抜くんじゃないぞ。
そうそう、お父さんの言う通りよ。頑張ってね、ハルカ。
予習復習もしっかりやるんだぞ。
ハルカさん kept silent。
お友達とはうまくやってる？
寮の隣部屋の子に迷惑かけるんじゃないぞ。
大丈夫よ、ハルカなら。ね、ハルカ。
そうか、ならいいんだが。
あのね、同じ会話して楽しい。
The two adults sitting before us put their chopsticks down and fell silent.
楽しいの？ねえ、こんなことしてて満足？三枝の家では、食事の時は静かにしなさいって教わったよ。私がね、口を開こうとするとね、スプーンで頭叩かれるんだよ。思いっきり何度もね、叩くんだよ。痛いって言ってもいけないの。言ったらね、どんどん回数増えるからね。だからね、黙って食べないといけないの。ねえ、楽しい。楽しい。
楽しいわよ、はるか。
ああ、楽しんでる。私たちは楽しんでる。
はるかさん suddenly flung her bowl against the wall.She then leaped to her feet and grabbed the tablecloth, pulling it with all her might. Utensils, glassware, plates, and the neat flower vase all crashed onto the floor.
楽しい？楽しいの？
I mean, the way I see it now is that they're maybe just trying to encourage just regular conversation at the dinner table and...Sure, they're saying the same things over and over, but it's because she is not really replying or engaging with the conversation they're trying to make. Maybe. And maybe they're trying to show her that this is a safe environment where she can say things. That they're not gonna hit her on the back of her head with a spoon or anything. You know? Maybe?Maybe this isn't something worth destroying the whole table over?
こんなのが、これのどこが？
はるかさん。
こんなの私楽しくない！
Come on, はるかさん。
入る。私、こんなとこいたくない！
どこへ帰るの？はるか。
はるかさんの mother murmured the question softly.Unable to think of a reply, Haruka-san bit her lip.
少なくとも、私はあなたを叩いたりしない。
There it is. There it is. Maybe she's kept in her mind with the things that happened to her and she never found a solution for the trouble in her mind. Yes. She is projecting, her trauma onto the people who actually are trying to provide a safe environment for her. And...I mean, I cannot fault her. Like, she's a child. That's a lot to bear on your own shoulders. And yeah. But, you know, for this to be overcome, there needs to be some active communication in first acknowledging that, hey, those things happened to you, but we are not those people. And, like she's doing now,We would never do that to you, so... You know. Yeah, and this is a casual defensive behavior. Yeah, of course, of course.
関係ないじゃん！放っておいてよ！
Haruka-san kicked her chair over and then left the dining room. I hurriedly chased after her. I heard the door shut. Outside? Haruka-san...Where did she go? I ran around looking for her, but Haruka-san was nowhere to be found. Having parents. I wonder if that's how a normal dinner is supposed to go. You know, that's
That's what I was saying. Parents are a little bit, you know, bit of a broken record, bit of a make sure you study, you know, tests are coming, or, you know, even if tests are over, you just still need to keep it up because, like, you don't slack off, but also don't, you know, create trouble for the neighbors in the dorm and get along with people. It's just what parents do. And it can be annoying, but it comes out of a place of genuine concern and love, so... How hard her mind must be broken down until it behaves so turtle-like her, yeah. Yeah. That is true. I muttered that as I made my way back. No problem. I get what you're saying. It's no problem. No grammar Nazi here. It's fine. No, I didn't see her anywhere. Turning to face the direction of the voice, I found Haruka-san's parents both standing there. Why should you apologize? No way. But aren't you her parents? I mean, they're not her real parents, they're trying. You said that kind of conversation is fun. If you look at Haruka-san, you can tell that's not true.
Moshimo. Tanoshika to kikarete. Ichido demo tanoshiku nai to kotaetara. Anoko wa dou kangaeru daro ka?
This is Haruka-san we're talking about. I can't imagine she'd have been hurt if they said it wasn't fun. She'd assume an attitude of, then let's not talk. There you go. It's damned if they do and damned if they don't. So she is also creating this impossible situation for them where they don't know how to act around her. If they act carefully, why are you acting carefully? If they... say things bluntly. Why are you saying it bluntly? Or let's not talk at all, you know? It's... everyone in this room is so toxic. Oh, Clinton. It's fine. Clinton is joking. It's fine. I also have a lot of practice understanding German natives trying to express themselves in English because I work with them every day. So I understand you perfectly so far. It's fine. Then the conversation would just get colder and colder. These people would keep up this sad routine as long as Haruka-san didn't change. These cold conversations had to continue. Until the day Haruka-san trusted them. They had to keep sitting around the dinner table and saying it was fun. Haruka-san, who hates everything, can't accept even warm words. This kind of fun is a spider's thread to her. A fine thread that seems like it could break at any moment.
わかっているから、うつろな会話を繰り返す。表面すら取り繕えなくなったら、本当に終わってしまう。期末さを感じても、一緒にいたいと願うだけしかできない。あの子が恨むのも当然だ。私たちは、あの子を助けに行ってやれなかった。
The entire thing was a horrible business. A horrible, miserable story. Who the hell was responsible for this terrible state of affairs? Just who? Haruka-san is she's the daughter of you and another man, isn't she? Neither of them answered. It looks like even Haruka-san doesn't know. Why haven't you told her? Oh, so there's more to unpack there. Okay. Why?
それは私たちの問題だからだ。勝手な言い草だと思うだろう。私もそう思う。
Then why not just tell me about it? Is Haruka-san your daughter?
言えない。
Then is she not your daughter?
言えない。
Why? Isn't Haruka-san your child? You should be the ones able to prove everything. Get a DNA test or something. Yeah, this is the first thing that went through my mind when they were explaining the story. But I didn't want to interrupt it at the time just to make this comment. Like, they somehow have this conviction that the two girls have the genes of two different men, although I'm not really sure how that is supposed to happen. If it's possible, I don't want to imagine it. It's fine, I don't need that picture in my head. Let's say that it's true, right? That they do have different fathers, and their main family, whatever, knew that the girls have the genes of two different men. But then they didn't know which one belonged to which. How do you know that part of the information, but you don't know the second? You know? Okay, so Riki is speaking reason here. If you're her father... Her father was adamant about it. Is Haruka-san not your child? I don't know if the voice that I spoke in was filled with anger or despair. Then why? Why? Both parents hung their heads. Sorry about that, it seems I forgot to mute my Chrome. There it is. That was my email notification. What should I do? What can I do? Objection, Your Honor, hearsay! Yes! Ah, oh, yes, yes, yes. Full of frustration more than anger, I made my way back to the school. Haruka-san, she stood there looking like a ghost.
Nee, Riki-kun.
Haruka-san, I was looking for you. You just took off. What? Research? Research on what? She said it so suddenly, I had no idea what she was talking about.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, sure, if that helps, you know, because it must be difficult to struggle with your own identity and like not know whose child you are. That's terrible. But in the end, like, neither her nor Kanata deserved the treatment that they've gotten, no matter whose child they are. It's just, ugh, so terrible. Because, like, I feel like, in a way, they are both envious of each other, of each other's position, but neither of their position are actually good ones. They're both terrible. So, yeah. But Haruka-san, what if she really was the wrong one, what would she do? But if you're not, then what are you gonna do about it? Do you want to trade places with Kanata? A promise? Ooh, there's a promise involved, okay. Haruka-san hung her head, muttering to herself. Then she looked up and spoke to me. Haruka-san was asking for my opinion. Ooh, choices. The grass on the other side is always greener. Maybe they don't know the downsides from the lies of each other. I mean, in a way, it makes sense for Haruka to not really understand it so much. Because she's always been on the side of being always torn down, rejected, had worst words thrown at her, how terrible she is, and blah 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 blah. And look at Kanata, how wonderful she is, right? So she has always had this fake perception that everyone is praising and just worshipping Kanata in a sense. And because she's always been rejected, but Kanata has been accepted, she kind of maybe unconsciously went to the conclusion that her position is better because at least she is accepted. and not rejected by everyone around her, but at the same time, Kanata is trapped in that position, and she like has to keep it up, I guess, which is no small feat, and also she is just paralyzed from that point of view, because as we saw earlier, she kinda envies Haruka's freedom, which she doesn't have. There is only one path forward for her in life, and that is to please the expectations of everyone. She cannot be her own self. So, that's not good either. They both view the world from the happiness theory Kanata mentioned, so Haruka believes she has to be Kanata to be happy and to bring Kanata down. Yeah. Do these kids get access to therapy? Not really. It seems not. Yeah. I don't know though if I have seen enough to believe that Haruka has this idea that things need to be balanced out, that her happiness is necessarily dependent on Kanata's misery. I feel like she's trying to cause trouble for Kanata to just kind of take it out on her, but I don't know if necessarily she believes in that theory. Although, obviously, the result is more or less the same, even if she doesn't or does not. She is indeed trying to tear Kanata down and believes if she succeeds, she might be happy. And, but the thing is, you can both be happy. There is definitely that kind of path forward in life. But obviously, it doesn't come at a small cost. Okay, so we're at this choice, which should be that's a good idea. Yeah, everything is fine. The when others feel bad like me, I don't feel alone anymore. Oh, okay. Maybe. I would have to think about it. Maybe, that could be one thing. Yeah, I think that's a fine idea. I'll help you out. Misery loves company. More like if Kanata is happy, I have to be sad. I see. Yeah, okay. I guess that can also make sense. It's just she needs to realize that Kanata is not actually happy. Like, they both need to understand and accept each other more. But at the same time, I don't fault them for not being at that place mentally, because they have had no space to be able to do that. They have just been put in awful situation after awful situation, and now they're in this like confrontational type of relationship at school. So there is no ground and no space for them to come to those kinds of terms. Yeah, no, I wasn't suggesting that you guys were making an argument that it's a good attitude. I do agree that it's a tendency that people have. It's true. I was just thinking if it applies to the situation or not. That was the thing that I was computing in my mind. Does it make sense from Haruka's point of view? Maybe, maybe not. I'm happy because you guys like this route. Yeah, it's it has given us a lot of food for thought and a space for debating things. I'll help you out.
Arigato, Riki-kun. Ja, ashita kara chousa kaishi da ne.
I got it. I'll see you tomorrow, Haruka-san.
Bye-bye, Riki-kun.
I waved to Haruka-san, then left. As I walked away, back toward the dorms, I looked back over my shoulder. Haruka-san was watching me go. During break time, I headed down to buy some juice. Ah, it's Haruka-san. Haruka-san was fixing up a poster that read "No running in the halls." The disciplinary committee. Haruka-san?
Konnichiwa, Riki-kun.
What are you doing?
Poster ga yaburarete ta kara sa. Naoshite ta toko.
And who tore it? I see. So you're fixing it. Won't Futaki-san get mad?
Huh? Ah.
Haruka-san nodded as she spun the red pen she was holding around in the air. I guess that's true. As we walked, as we talked with each other, several students passed by whispering to each other. Looks like the rumor mill hasn't let up.
それも気にしない。
Haruka-san returned the red marker to her pocket and gave a little smile.
じゃあね, Riki-kun.
Yeah, see you after school. We went our separate ways. Haruka-san and I met up in the cafeteria. There we began our research. Good work earlier. What kind of research can two kids make in this? I'm really curious how they're gonna approach it. Oh, I think I missed Takasaki's message. Honestly, best route into personal confidence was very interesting. Yeah, it's interesting.
それよりリキ君、私考えてたんだけど、まあ私はあまり頭良くないので、ちょっと手こずったけど。
No, don't put yourself down, girl.
やり方は分かったから、用紙とか揃えてみたんだ。Haruka-san
spoke quickly, cutting me off. Wait a second, Haruka-san. What are you talking about?
あのね。 とりあえず戸籍の写しを見てみようと思うんだけど、どうかな?
Ah, that sounds good. I've seen a certificate of residence once, but I've never browsed through any official family records.
うん。生まれた当時、二人を調べた後、分けて登録してあるのかもしれないし。
Can you even get your hands on that? But how do we get our hands on the records? I love it. I don't know, sometimes I have these moments where I'm on the exact same wavelength as the main character. And I say something and then the main character says the same thing and I'm like, okay, cool, I'm definitely like in the role here. They can recreate a conception for science. Yeah, that would definitely help with the research for sure.
ちょっと調べてみたんだけど、郵送申請でもいいらしいんだ。Haruka-san
showed me the documents she had. Ah, so we just send in these documents to request it.
うん、そうみたい。
Are they gonna give it to you though? Haruka-san started writing.
じゃあ出してくるね。近くに郵便ポストってあったっけ?
Yeah, I think. There's one by the school gates. I believe I saw Kud mailing something there once. At least I felt I had. Also, what's going on with Kud? Because the thing, the scene earlier just really left me a bit. Huh? What happened? She was so sadness. I know it's not her route, but I would have liked to know what the heck was going on.
そこに出してくる。ちょっと待っててね、リキ君。
Okay. You have a stamp and everything?
行ってきたよ。
Was there a mailbox there?
あったよ。 ありがとう, リキ君。 クドコはどこに出してたのかな?
It looked like she was writing to someone. Overseas correspondence, I think.
ああ、ペンパルってやつか。 クドコらしいな。
ちょっと、それは置いといて。
これだけですぐわかるとは思えないよね。
I guess next... Ah, we could get the mother and child health record from after you were born.
母子手帳?
Yeah, you know, after a child is born and the mom goes in for a checkup with the child, they make a record for the information. A record of the information. How do you know that, Riki? If we could get our hands on it, there might be something there. To be honest, an actual diary from her parents would be even better. Though we had no idea where something like that might be found.
なるほど。リキ君さすがですよ。頭いいな。でも、数日は家に行けないかな。
Why?
あいつが家に行く日が続くから。I
see.
うん。だから、誰もいない時にしようよ。そっちの方が探しやすいし。ね。I
got it. Let's do that. I guess that's all for today then. While we were talking, I had started growing hungry.
マフィン焼いてきたけど、食べる?リキ君。
Muffins! Yeah, I'll have some. Haruka-san, your muffins are great. I really like them. Haruka-san blushed a little. It's not flattery, I'm being serious.
So?
Aw, that's so cute! And so, despite Haruka-san's embarrassment, we happily shared the muffins. Okay, cool. We can end at muffin time. 2 hours, almost, and a quarter. It's a good spot. It's close to midnight for me, so apologies for being late. But yeah, I think we filled in the time just nicely. And we will take it from here next time and see where their investigation goes and what happens there. But what about lunch? Well, we will find next time what about lunch. Also, maybe one cool thing to point out, since it was mentioned that the voices are cool. It came up some streams ago when I made a comment on this, that actually both Haruka and Kanata are voiced by the same actress. Now you're in. Sorry guys, sorry to disappoint. I really gotta go, but I will chill a little bit in... Let's do this. And we can do this for a second, although I'm not the best sight at the moment. I'm super tired, but yeah, all good. Oh. Yeah, stretch. Yeah, thanks for being here and for the nice conversation. That was very cool to debate and have everyone chime in. And yeah. And Clinton finally was able to see that we have depth and painful things happening in this visual novel, aside from baseball. And just goofing around. So yeah, thank you guys for being there. You make the streams what they are with your lovely presence in the chat and the nice time that you could have spent anywhere else, but you decided to spend it with me. So yeah, I had a really, really fun time. I appreciate you all being here. I will be very short tonight because I have to go take care of some things and then I have to wake up very early tomorrow. So I cannot hang out too much in a big Zoom moment, but I can make up for it in some of the upcoming streams. So I'll see you again Thursday with a bit more Stray, and we will continue Little Busters next week. Maybe it's worth mentioning that next week I think I will do streams on Tuesday for Little Buster that stays there, but for Stray I think I will do it Wednesday because I would like to have Thursday off. So thank you again, hope to see you next time. Until then, take care, love you, and yeah, I appreciate your presence once again. This was awesome, and maybe we can do a repeat and finish off the route. Take care, bye.